expires on at the same instant the ear was assailed. So Sinclair uses rhetorical devices to make his reader feel really disgusted by this paragraph and hopefully generate some sympathy for the animals and the workers. And one rhetorical device he uses is polysyndeton in the Senate. One example is, and meantime another swung up, and then another, and another, and squealing. And that makes the reader keep reading and just keep stacking everything up, all the bad things, or just keep on stacking up and up and up. And it generates some disgust for the industry and sympathy for the animals. Another rhetorical device is antithesis. The sentence, for the fifth sentence, he says, there were high squeals and low squeals, grunts and wails. There would be a momentary lull and then a fresh outburst. And it kind of makes the sentence stick out because there's so many contradictions, so there's so many things going on and you really can't concentrate on just one. So there's this flood of noise coming at you. It helps you imagine how the workers must feel and it generates sympathy. And then his choice of diction instills a sense of fear in his readers. Even though it's just a story, it gives you as a reader an idea of what all of the workers were going through, which is fear and not knowing what's going on. So by using polysyndeton and antithesis and diction, it gives the reader a look at the same fear that the workers get